Our read today will be Great Scientists. Great scientists are persevering and never deterred by difficulties. Persevering means determined, and deterred means they are never distracted by difficulties. Michael Faraday is regarded as one of the most distinguished scientists and inventors of modern times, and his work on electricity is still a subject of study in the form of Faraday's laws. But few know his inspirational life story, which is all about courage and fighting against all odds. Michael Faraday was born into a poverty-stricken family in a dirty London suburb. He suffered from a speech defect as a child. He would pronounce rabbit as wabbit. He could not even say his own name and would call himself Faraday. Other children laughed at him, and teachers did not help him either. When he was 12, his mother was forced to take him out of school, thus putting an end to his formal education. At 13, however, he started working with a bookbinder, binding hundreds of books during the day and staying up all night to read them. Reading thus became his obsession. Obsession means something we desire. One day he came across a book on electricity, which had been sent to his master for binding. He started reading it and was completely hooked. That was his first introduction to the subject of electricity, which soon became his lifelong fascination. Faraday was still poor at 21. Once a friend gave him a free ticket to a public lecture and demonstration by the renowned chemist Humphrey Davy at London's Royal Institution. Davy's work on chemicals and electrical lighting was the subject of conversation amongst the scientists at that age. 70 years later, across the Atlantic Ocean in USA, the same work enabled Thomas Edison to produce the first consistent light bulb. That day in 1812, Faraday was spellbound by Davy's lecture. He kept on taking notes about the mysterious force of electric fluid. He was so engrossed in the lecture that he forgot to applaud with the rest of the crowd. Applaud is to clap hands after a speech is done. When he went back, his notes were so comprehensive that he bound them into a book, meaning to gift it to Davy someday. Faraday decided that day that he didn't just want to sell books, he wanted to be a great scientist, good enough to write his own books. Davy became his role model, but there was a problem. He did not have a social status, money, or the education to pursue science. Faraday thought it would be wonderful if Davy became his mentor. But Davy did not agree initially. Faraday was not dejected. He kept trying. Destiny had a strange plan in store for him. A few years later, a chemical explosion happened inside Davy's lab, and he was temporarily blinded. He now needed an assistant with an excellent memory to help him. He was reminded of Faraday and decided to hire him as his secretary. Davy never believed Faraday could do anything in the field of science, going by his social status and education. He therefore dismissed Faraday's aspirations and advised him to stick to bookbinding. But Faraday was relentless. He worked day and night and learned as much as he could about Davy's experiment. Soon Faraday became indispensable to Davy and was promoted to his lab assistant. This was his first step towards a scientific career. Though much of his job now was cleaning labs, at least he got to see some of Davy's leading experiments. Even then, Davy did not have much hope for Faraday. Then Faraday got another chance to prove himself. One day, Faraday tried to recreate a famous electromagnetism experiment with fellow chemist William Wollaston. Exploring why, when an electric current is applied to a wire, it caused the wire to behave like a magnet. Obviously, the forces were connected, but nobody had figured out how to make it happen continuously. Davy believed that if he could find out why it happened and controlled it, there could be many practical applications of the force. But he was unable to figure it out and was frustrated. He then teased Faraday, asking him to try his hand at it after he was done cleaning the lab. Within a few days, Faraday solved the problem. In fact, he went further and the result was the first induction motor, which converted electric current into a continuous mechanical motion. The induction motor spurred a revolution. Fans, air conditioning, sewing machines, photographs, power tools, cars, and even trains and aeroplane engines grew out of the simple device, which was born out of mockery directed at Faraday. Mockery is teasing someone. Faraday became a celebrity scientist overnight. Nobody now cared about his social status or education. This young man had just created a revolution. One would think, as a teacher, Davy was happy at his pupil's achievement, but in reality, he was jealous. People started telling Davy that all of his discoveries, the best was Faraday himself. This made him even more jealous. An angry Davy gave Faraday an impossible task to keep him out of his way. He handed him a piece of Bavarian glass, which is used in the lenses in telescopes and microscopes, and asked him to reverse engineer it. Bavarian glass was manufactured by a secret complicated process, and Danny knew that with the equipment available in the lab, Faraday would never be able to accomplish the task. The piece of glass became a significant thing in his life. Faraday had never given up, attitude, and he respected Davy, so he accepted the assignment. Despite knowing that it would be a very difficult task, he toiled for 4 years without any help from Davy, and as expected, failed. Toil means he tried and tried for 4 long years. Faraday never learned the secret, and this remained his first failure as a scientist. To remind himself of these difficult times, he kept a single glass brick off his shelf as a souvenir. Souvenir is a memory, a thing that you keep as your memory. This would inspire him during difficult times. In 1829, Davy died and Faraday succeeded him as head of the laboratory. He was free to pursue whatever he liked, and he made another revolutionary discovery. He noticed that if he moved a magnet, it could produce electric current. Thus, he could now convert motion into electricity. This is how the electrical generator was born, something still used today to generate all kinds of power, like dynamos and other devices. Faraday was now a legend. In 1840, he developed memory loss, which continued for the rest of his life. But the disease did not stop him. He persevered, starting a complicated experiment to prove that light was closely related to electricity and magnetism, a novel thought in those times. Remember that piece of Bavarian glass Faraday had kept on his shelf? He was determined to convert the remainder of his first major failure into an instrument that, in the presence of a magnet, Light could be isolated into a single wave rather than spreading out randomly in all directions, a concept called polarization. He then took the old age experiment of sprinkling iron filings on a sheet of paper near a magnet, making circular patterns. He went on to prove that these patterns were not a property of the iron filings. In fact, they were due to the invisible magnetic fields that filled the empty space around the magnet and hence disturbed the fillings. This was where his lack of formal education went against him. Faraday did not know much about advanced mathematics, so he just copied the iron filling patterns on his hand. He was unable to explain them in the form of mathematical equations. He made hundreds of such drawings, but without equations, they were not accepted. Fortune favored the brave Faraday once again when he met James Maxwell, a wealthy educated physicist, well versed in mathematics. He was willing to work with Faraday. It was Maxwell who translated Faraday's idea into a set of equations that are now called Maxwell's equations. Their combined work has helped us in many ways. Electronics and communication systems today are designed around their discoveries. Someday, we might even be able to communicate with aliens along different galaxies using the products of these discoveries. Faraday's life started with difficulties, but as a great scientist, he met each difficulty with perseverance and conviction. He was given impossible tasks, which he undertook as challenges and opportunities. He epitomizes what the Walt Disney character Pinocchio says: "When you wish upon a star, it does not matter who you are." This is from the introduction of Reignited by APJ Abdul Kalam and Srijan Pal Singh. What we learn from this extract is that we should be determined. We should do with all hard work. If we put in all our efforts, then nothing can stop us. If we have difficulties in our way, then we should take it as challenges. We should take it as a new opportunity to learn something new. Nothing can stop us from achieving something great.